Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Alhamdulillah rabbil alameen. Wa salatu wa salamu ala rasulillah wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Amma ba'd. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear brothers and sisters, welcome back. Just before the break, we were discussing the second principle of tazkiyah, and that is dua. And that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the one who had his past and future forgiven, he would ask Allah to purify himself. And we have this in the hadith of Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu. He says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he read فَأَلْهَمَهَا فُجُورَهَا وَتَقْوَاهَا, this is the ayah in Surah Al-Shams, which we discussed in our previous episodes when we discussed the importance of tazkiyah. So when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited this ayah, he would say, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha anta waliyuha wa mawlaha. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, Allahumma ati nafsi taqwaha wa zakkiha anta khayru man zakkaha anta waliyuha wa mawlaha. So he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say, Allahumma, oh Allah, bring to myself taqwa, make myself adorned with taqwa. This is what he would say, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then he would say, wazakkiha, and purify it, meaning purify myself. Anta khayru man zakkaha, that you, Allah, you are the best who can purify it. And you are the best of purifiers. Anta waliyuha wa mawlaha, and you are indeed its guardian. You are indeed its guardian. So this is what Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam would say in his dua. Now, again, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the person who is pure, Allah purified him, his chest was washed twice. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, who Allah promised that his past and future is forgiven, he would say this sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And I want you to note from this, brothers and sisters, a point when reading the Quran, because we see from this hadith how he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam made this dua when he read the ayah. And this teaches us the importance of being interactive in our ibadah when worshipping Allah, reciting the Quran. For from the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was to ask Allah for goodness when he read the ayat of goodness, was to ask Allah for protection from Jahannam, from harm, when he read the ayat of punishment. And as we see here, he's asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for goodness when he sallallahu alayhi wa sallam read that it is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who gave the self the ability to discern between righteousness and weakness. Now, again, brothers and sisters, just before the break, I spoke about our situation with dua, right? What is our situation with dua? I highlighted for you certain scenarios, but we have another scenario also which I want to highlight, because, you know, I want to see our sessions as a heart-to-heart where we can frankly discuss certain things. Today, many of us experience different circumstances. And when we experience these circumstances, in many a case, we think about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala right at the end, right? We might have a financial problem, immediately we start looking at our networks, at our contacts, who can lend us the money, and so on and so forth. When the first point then would be to turn to Allah, raise your hands, and ask from the King of all providers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, ar-Razzaq. Ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to provide for you. Because even the person that you would see as a contact, and a person who Allah has made a means, and this is the point to note, Allah has made them a means. It is Allah who made them a means, right? So why not turn to the one who made them a means and the one who can make them a means before we turn to them? We must pay attention to this, my dear brothers and sisters. Even when it comes to exams and so on and so forth, we put our trust in the extra tuition, in the online programs, in the online academies and so on and so forth. How much dua are we making? And in a lot of cases, as I have come to see, we ask everyone else to make dua and we're the last person making dua. Everybody, we say, make dua for my exams, make dua for my job interview, make dua for my business investment. Everyone, we tell our parents, our siblings, our brothers, our sisters, our relatives, make dua, make dua, make dua, whilst we not even making dua. Allahul Musta'an. So dua is very important. And for us to become purified, we need to better ourselves with dua, because this principle here, brothers and sisters, is the principle that teaches us that tazkiyah cannot happen except with dua. Dua is the means of attaining tazkiyah, and we know this because of principle number one, which teaches us that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the purifier. My dear brothers and sisters, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ayyuhan nas, antumul fuqara u ilallah, wallahu huwa al-ghaniyul hamid. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O mankind, you are poor. You are the poor ones. And Allah is rich. And all praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Not just any praise, not this concept of just saying thank you or praising someone who's praiseworthy, like we do in the dunya. No, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says Al-Hamid, this is referring to Al-Hamd ma'al mahabba wa ta'azim. Let me explain this to you. When Allah says that all hamd belongs to Allah, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, all praises belong to Allah, whether you praise Him, whether you don't praise Him, whether you remember to praise Him, whether you forget to praise Him, whatever your circumstance, all praises belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Which praise? That praise which is of the highest caliber. That is the praise that belongs to Allah. Why? Because the praise that Allah is talking about is praise that comes from a person who loves Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in a glorified way. Allahu Akbar. They recognize the bounties of Allah upon them. They know that no one can give them what Allah has given them. So it stems and causes to grow within them a glorified love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the praise that comes as a result of this glorified love, as our scholars say, مَعَ الْمَحَبَّ وَالتَّعَظِيمِ, a person who praises Allah with glorified love, this is a praise that no one else deserves besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And this mighty praise, لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ, is only for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Lord of the worlds. This is important. Allah tells us, you are poor and Allah is rich and Allah is Al-Hamid. He is the praiseworthy one subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah says, إِيَّشَأْ يُذْهِبْكُمْ وَيَأْتِ بِخَلْقٍ جَدِيدٍ. Allah says, if Allah willed, He would get rid of you. And He would come with a new nation who praised Allah better, who worshipped Allah better, who was more purified. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala boastfully then says, وَمَا ذَلِكَ عَلَى اللَّهِ بِعَزِيزٍ. And for your information, this is not even difficult for Allah. It's not difficult. You know, we... tasks are asked of us and we say, well, that's a difficult task. Allah is telling us that removing all of us and coming with a better creation is nothing. It's not even difficult for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to do. So, and the reason why I'm citing this for you, my dear brothers and sisters, is that so we can become acute in our understanding of how in need we are of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how dua should be major in our life and how dua needs to happen for tazkiyah to come into our life. And by Allah, I'm sure when you asked yourself that question, that how much tazkiyah do I need, you really understood that you definitely need it. Whether it's in big dosages, whether it's in small dosages, it's needed. And if it's needed, we can't be free from dua. For indeed, we are the poor of the poor. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the rich of the rich. Subhanahu wa ta'ala, Rabbul Izzati wal Jalal, Al-Wahid al-Qahhar, Al-Ahad, Al-Fard al-Samad, الذي لم يلد ولم يولد ولم يكن له كفوا أحد. Whilst we're on the topic, my dear brothers and sisters, let me share with you a hadith, a powerful hadith. It's a hadith Qudsi. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and this is in the hadith of Abi Dharr radiallahu anhu. He says that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, that Allah said. So he's telling us what Allah said subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ya ibadi, O my slaves, إِنِّي حَرَّمْتُ الظُّلْمَ عَلَىٰ نَفْسِي وَجَعَلْتُهُ مُحَرَّمًا بَيْنَكُمْ فَلَا تَظَالَمُوا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my slaves, indeed I have made oppression haram upon myself, forbidden upon myself. Allah has forbidden Himself from oppressing anybody, and Allah has made it forbidden amongst us to oppress each other. فَلَا تَظَالَمُوا. Thus do not oppress one another. Then he goes on to say, and I'm going to read to you the Arabic so you can feel it, and then I'll give you the translation. He says, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, Ya ibadi, kullukum dal, illa man hadaytuhu, fastahduni ahdikum. Ya ibadi, kullukum ja'i', illa man at'amtuhu, fastat'imuni at'imkum. Allahu Akbar. Ya ibadi, kullukum arin, illa man kasawtuhu, fastaksuni aksukum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Ya ibadi, innakum tukhti'una billayli wal nahar, wa ana aghfiru dhunuba jami'an, fastaghfiruni aghfir lakum. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, all of you are astray, except for those I have guided. So seek guidance of me and I shall guide you. Allah is telling us this, my dear brothers and sisters. How can it not be a principle from the principles of tazkiyah to make dua? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servants, all of you are hungry except for those I have fed. So seek food of me and I shall feed you. Allah says, O my servants, all of you are naked except for those I have clothed. So seek clothing of me and I shall clothe you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, O my servants, I forgive all sins. So seek forgiveness of me and I shall forgive you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala before that last part says, إِنَّكُمْ تُخْطِئُونَ بِاللَّيْلِ وَالنَّهَارِ, that you sin in the day and you sin at night. وَأَنَا أَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا, and it is Allah who forgives all sins. فَاسْتَغْفِرُونِ, so seek forgiveness for your sins. أَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ, Allah doesn't say, I will forgive you. Allah says, consider yourself forgiven. This is, I mean, I'm not being literal with the translation, but this is the real meaning, brothers and sisters. Indeed, Allah يَغْفِرُ الذُّنُوبَ جَمِيعًا, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgives all sins. Now for anyone who, you know, sat with me just with a cursory understanding, going through or following the translation that I shared, you will see indeed how poor we are and how in need of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala you and I are. And the reason why I've highlighted all this for us is to cement the second principle of tazkiyah, and that's the principle of dua. Principle number one, Allah is the purifier. Principle number two, tazkiyah does not happen except with dua. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. My dear brothers and sisters, I'll leave you with these two principles to ponder over, to think over, to digest. And don't forget, it's not enough just to think, but what's needed is action. What I would like you to do is benchmark yourself, especially against the second principle, and figure out how you're going to become better with your dua. For wallahi, we do have issues in our lives. And if we only bettered ourselves with dua, we would see those issues vanish. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us the understanding. Ameen. I love you all for the sake of Allah. May Allah gather us again. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.